Well, hi guys, it's your boy Natty B. I'm back again with another new video. If you are new here, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. It helps a lot. Dr. Cisse, do you think our country is progressing?
And the way things are going, our country was far better off 25 years ago, 50 years ago than we are now. And it will get worse in 25 years' time if the current trends continue.
What did you think the citizens should know about their vote?
The citizens must understand the value of their vote. They must know why they should be voting and how their vote should be able to change their lives.
Can there be any meaningful democracy whereby the youths are not enlightened?
Democracy itself is premised on choice. People have to make informed choices. But for you to make an informed choice, you must be able to be equipped with the knowledge you need to make that informed choice. Otherwise, the same politics will continue. Police of bag of rice. You give people bag of rice, you get their voters card. That should change in this country.
Relax. Many words do not fill your basket. I will give you a strategic.
How many destructive contracts are going on in the Gambia?
The fish meal factories is bad for the country. They are depleting our fish resources. They are polluting our environment. What is the Gambia getting from it? The black sand mine contract they give is not good for the country. How much is Gambia? How much are the people of Batakunku, Sanyang, and Tenje getting from the black sand, which is under there?
What did you think the government should base their contracts on?
Even if you are giving contracts, these contracts must be ensure. It must not only ensure that Gambians of today benefit from this contract, but it must ensure the welfare of future generations.
Kimpada, are our leaders active?
Soon, on star loose on a blood clot place. On don't know how one Gambia on a sleep. Adam Abaro asleep, Ahmad Ba asleep, Halifa Salah asleep, Lawyer Dabo asleep, all of the government leader them asleep.
I come look at this.
Kimpada, are people still blaming Jambe for what he did in the past?
The government we ono put there and make the people suffer. Everybody are blame Yaya Jambe. Look how long Yaya Jambe left. Every day ono blame Yaya Jambe.
Now the platform is open for everybody. Anybody can just sit at your corner and say anything.
Nobody will go frustrated for this country. They never tell you.
People are tired of suffering.
Mr. Barrow, what's your qualification?
Yes, I'm a high school graduate.
Barrow, I have you guys file here. You and Dr. Cisse, who do you think contribute the most towards the change?
I contributed more than Dr. Cisse. As far as this change is concerned.
Yeah, how many percent did you think you contribute?
My tour with the UDP, our bill was $1.5 million. I contributed 80% of the bill to make sure we go on that tour. And that tour make the change in this country.
Your brain is carcass. That's what we have. Read more books. Even check your encyclopedia. Oh God, I thank you for...
PhD holders, where are they?
Are you asking me?
When I talk about this, I lose my temper. I get irritated.
Do me a favor, please. Get out of here. Get out of here, man. Shit, I'm saying...
Mr. President, what did you think about the intellectuals who were sacked by Jambe?
But there are a lot of intellectuals who were sacked in the system. Who were here in the Gambia, they were sacked. They fold their hands. They become beggars because they are innovative. They couldn't create anything for themselves.
Dr. Cisse, it's like we are forgetting something. How about the reforms?
The reforms must take place. Otherwise, it will be a grave betrayal of the Gambian people. A grave betrayal of those who died. If we go for 2021 elections without the reforms, it doesn't make any sense.
Gambiala Boro, Ismaila Doctor, Ismaila Cisse. Funding kile langa kumakilim fale Gambia. Naturally Gambia kanal ju sukunkono. Alanga na own party londi. Katu nyinke barungo longa bil sindi nyato nko puriye Gambia look after them. Na look after Gambia, nobody in a yacht.
And today the problems are many. 60% of our population are living in urban Gambia. That is a big problem. It's a big mess. Because there's nothing in rural Gambia. No hospitals, no schools, no jobs, nothing. But urban Gambia was not built for 60% of our population. The water infrastructure was not built for 60% of our population. The electricity grids are not built for 50% of our population. The roads are not built for that. That is why there is so much traffic congestion everywhere. The houses are not enough. That is why, because of that pressure, 100% hike in house prices. And the landlords are exploiting our people. There are no institutions to protect the tenants. The prices go up left, right, and center. Crime is in the increase. So many young people in urban Gambia, no jobs, frustrated, hopeless. That is why people are building the way they want, because there is so much profit